Kampala traders have temporarily closed their businesses for the second day since yesterday. This in response to the cancellation of a highly anticipated meeting with President Yoweri Museveni to resolve the contested tax regimes, including the rolling out of IFRS. The traders' meeting with the president, which was scheduled for July 31st, was called off via an SMS from Kampala Minister Misa Kabanda, sparking off outrage among the business community. Security forces were deployed strategically in the central business district to ensure law and order. KASITA spokesperson Issa Sachito condemned the cancellation of the meeting as unprofessional and disrespectful. The traders have expressed frustration over what they see as a lack of consideration for their concerns. Many say they are struggling financially due to their current business challenges, excavated by what they perceive as excessive taxation and regulatory burdens. The chairperson of the Federation for Uganda Traders Association, John Kabanda, is however optimistic that the president will address their demands soon.
Traders or the trading community is one of the major stakeholders in the economy of this country. So we thought the government is taking us for granted. And also, she was emphasizing about submission of proposals without mentioning about the challenges which we have been engaging the government and which we clearly presented to His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. So that's why the traders had to communicate in a more peaceful way.
Today, the Kampala business district was characterized by merchandise spread across the street walkways, which led to congestion in the city. Nonetheless, most of the businesses and shops remained closed except for a few. The cancellation of the meeting was attributed to renovations at Kolo ceremonial grounds, but Sachito and other traders are not satisfied with this explanation. Wise Wabageya, the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Works and Transport, announced the new fees for the category of A, A1 and B1 classes in a statement dated July 31, 2024. Class A permits covers motorcycles with no sidecar. Class A is for motorcycles with a cubic capacity not exceeding 125cc, and Class B1 is designated for motorized tricycles and quadricycles. Bagaya informed the general public that the fees had been reduced effective August 1, 2024. This move has excited border board operators, who convened a press conference to express their gratitude to the president for fulfilling his pledge to have the licenses fees revised. In May this year, President Yoweri Museveni promised that the government would reduce these costs following the complaints by the riders that they were very high. The learner's driving license, which is valid for 3 months, will now cost 40,000 shillings, down from 60,000 shillings, while a new full driving license for a year will cost 100,000 shillings, down from 135,000 shillings. A new full driving license for 3 years will cost 130,000 shillings, down from 230,000 shillings, and that for 5 years will cost 250,000 shillings, down from 330,000 shillings. Renewing a driving license for 1 year will now cost 70,000 shillings, down from 130,000 shillings. For 3 years, 100,000 shillings, down from 210,000 shillings. And for 5 years, 200,000 shillings, down from 310,000 shillings. For duplication, it will cost 60,000 shillings and the same amount for extension of expiring driving licenses. According to Bagaya, the fees depend on the type of driving license you're applying for and its validity period, but the driving licenses are valid for 1 year, 3 and 5 years. The executive director of the Uganda Bureau of Statistics, Dr. Chris Mukiza, has issued an assurance to pay the remaining 1,519 of 114,327 census enumerators. Speaking to journalists at WUBO's head office in Kampala, Mukiza revealed that these enumerators had discrepancies concerning their identification, whereas others lost tablets and power banks, among other devices, during the operations. He says these can only be paid after returning the missing gadgets.
Which is 98.7% of the enumerators have so far been paid all their entitlements. Whereas 1,519 are yet to be paid.
Mokiza also revealed that the Bureau is set to carry out an independent post-enumeration survey as a measure of quality assurance for the census outcomes. He has appealed to the public to cooperate with the officers who are going to carry out the exercise in all 135 districts and 11 cities across the country.
Informing them in advance to cooperate with field staff to ensure accurate data is captured. All LC chairpersons, 1 to 3, I encourage to mobilize their respective selected villages.
According to the Uganda Census 2024 preliminary results released, Uganda's population has increased from 34.8 million people in the 2014 census to 45,935.46 people, marking an increase of 11.3 million people.